If you want to start to improve things in your life, you have to take on responsibility of recognizing that you're the only one that can change and make things work for yourself. When you're attempting to work with people who look like you, you have to remember that you have to follow the people who want to work with you and believe in what you're doing. You can't expect people who don't have any interest in what you're doing to work with you. It's not going to work. So when you run into the people who are about what you're about, be their best friend. Be the help that they need and you need to each other. Work out a way to accomplish the goals that you really want to accomplish. Prepare to dealing with individuals who's not going to work with you, trust in what you're saying, and back you when it's needed. I highly recommend that you follow that and you can accomplish all your goals. I would like to hear response videos and get feedback from people who think like I do. I'm on a mission to improve and better our society with like-minded people who feels the way I do in order to make a difference. I have many different talents and skills. I would like to share with the right people, and I would like the right people to share their talents and skills with me. Once we do that, we can accomplish more goals collectively together. So I'm hoping that you'll be open to that. Peace. If you want to start to improve things in your life, you have to take on responsibility of recognizing that you're the only one that can change and make things work for yourself. When you're attempting to work with people who look like you, you have to remember that you have to follow the people who want to work with you and believe in what you're doing. You can't expect people who don't have any interest in what you're doing to work with you. It's not going to work. So when you run into the people who are about what you're about, be their best friend. Be the help that they need and you need to each other. Work out a way to accomplish the goals that you really want to accomplish. Prepare to dealing with individuals who's not going to work with you, trust in what you're saying, and back you when it's needed. I highly recommend that you follow that and you can accomplish all your goals. I would like to hear response videos and get feedback from people who think like I do. I'm on a mission to improve and better our society with like-minded people who feels the way I do in order to make a difference. I have many different talents and skills. I would like to share with the right people, and I would like the right people to share their talents and skills with me. Once we do that, we can accomplish more goals collectively together. So I'm hoping that you'll be open to that. Peace.
Man, always remember, your truth is your truth. Never allow someone who have scarred your life, kept you from your children, disregarded all your emotions, and disrespected you as a human being to dictate anything to you whatsoever. When someone does that to you, they are truly your enemies. Ignore them, don't associate with them, keep your distance, and focus on bettering yourself in any and every way you can. If you have children that disown you, disrespect you, because they want to side with their mother, let that happen, because sooner or later, they're going to come your way. And when they do, don't waste your time, because it's obvious and clear whose side they're on. Men, you can always make more children. You can always have what you want. Don't let some force-keeping individual try to stop you from building your empire. Remember, you are a lone star, and you can accomplish your goals without them. They never been there for you in the first place. Most females are in their life for themselves. They're not here to gratify you, cater to you, or help you in any way. They will use you till they use you up, and that's it. So don't focus on them to cater to. Ignore them and disregard them as they do you, and you will live a better life. Word to the wise, stay wise, and keep away from vindictive evil monstrosities in this lifetime.
Men, I highly recommend you do not pursue women, females, anymore in this country, because their narrative is derogatory and not suitable for sane heterosexual men in this society. If they see you as a tool to use as an ATM bank and have no interest in you, no emotional connection, don't have no desire to do that, stay far away from these type of females. If a lady, female, woman, opposite sex of a man, tells you she's not interested in anything other than getting money, then I suggest you leave her alone, because that's what I consider prostitution. Now, if you're looking for a prostitute, go for it. Go for it. But don't blame nobody or complain about it later when she's at your pockets for anything that will happen that will take away from you and give to her. If they have no respect for you, leave them be. If they don't care for you, leave them be. If they don't want to build anything with you, leave them be. If they're trying to find fault in everything you do, leave them be. Men, we need to stop assisting individuals who has no proper right to anything you have access to your capabilities. They are not reasonable, they are not logical, and they will destroy you if you allow them to.
Greetings. This is Waz Nubian, and I want to explain some things. Men of color, please, don't allow a woman to try to control you and how you want to do things for yourself. If she's not cooperating or listening to you, then don't waste time trying to communicate with her. Don't try to encourage her to do anything that she's not willing to do for you without you doing it, and her comments are not needed in what you're doing. You need to focus on making sure you get what you need done appropriately. They will try to shame you, insult, guilt, and put you down on any kind of level to try to be correct, even if they're wrong. Men, stop allowing yourself to be drained by females that don't respect you, acknowledge you, or look at anything that you're doing as a good thing. It's clear that she's not going to work with you. It's clear that she don't respect you. It's clear that she's not going to participate in anything you're trying to do for you and your children. So you have to separate and have no communication with the mothers of your children, or no communication, especially if you are involved in a life as a full-time parent. Do not waste your time. Do not call. That's what you do.
Men, always remember, your truth is your truth. Never allow someone who have scarred your life, kept you from your children, disregarded all your emotions, and disrespected you as a human being to dictate anything to you whatsoever. When someone does that to you, they are truly your enemies. Ignore them, don't associate with them, keep a distance, and focus on bettering yourself in any and every way you can. If you have children that disown you, disrespect you, because they want to side with their mother, let that happen, because sooner or later, they're going to come your way. And when they do, don't waste your time, because it's obvious and clear whose side they're on. Men, you can always make more children. You can always have what you want. Don't let some force-keeping individual try to stop you from building your empire. Remember, you are a lone star, and you can accomplish your goals without them. They've never been there for you in the first place. Most females are in their life for themselves. They're not here to gratify you, cater to you, or help you in any way. They will use you till they use you up, and that's it. So don't focus on them to cater to. Ignore them and disregard them as they do you, and you will live a better life. Word to the wise, stay wise, and keep away from vindictive evil monstrosities in this lifetime. Men, always remember, your truth is your truth. Never allow someone who have scarred your life, kept you from your children, disregarded all your emotions, and disrespected you as a human being to dictate anything to you whatsoever. When someone does that to you, they are truly your enemies. Ignore them, don't associate with them, keep a distance, and focus on bettering yourself in any and every way you can. If you have children that disown you, disrespect you, because they want to side with their mother, let that happen, because sooner or later, they're going to come your way. And when they do, don't waste your time, because it's obvious and clear whose side they're on. Men, you can always make more children. You can always have what you want. Don't let some force-keeping individual try to stop you from building your empire. Remember, you are a lone star, and you can accomplish your goals without them. They've never been there for you in the first place. Most females are in their life for themselves. They're not here to gratify you, cater to you, or help you in any way. They will use you till they use you up, and that's it. So don't focus on them to cater to. Ignore them and disregard them as they do you, and you will live a better life. Word to the wise, stay wise, and keep away from vindictive evil monstrosities in this lifetime.
Okay, here's the simple rules. Rule number one, if a woman can't cook for you, she's not for you. If a woman can't make your clothes, she's not for you. If a woman can't work with you on business deals and help you build the income that you both will enjoy, then you don't need to be with her. If she's not dressed naturally and have all her natural looks and not hiding behind makeup or false nails, false eyebrows, false anything, don't deal with it. If she's overweight, out of shape, don't deal with it. If she have other men, children in her life, you don't need to be with her. Let the children father deal with her because they made children together. If you have these type of things, then you make sure she bring that to the table. If you allow yourself to be a part of a female who tells you to take her out to dinner, to open the door for her, to cater to her, to put your life online, to protect her if she says something foul to someone or initiate a problem in a relationship with someone else and expect you to defend her, you're mentally ill. Do not be around these type of females. If you're dealing with a female that wants you to buy her everything, take her out, pay her bills and all that, but she's not your wife, she's not having your babies, and she's not responsible for anything that present her in the light that she will be your mate, then I suggest you stop dealing with this female. If you're dealing with a female that constantly criticizing you, finding fault and trying to set you up or violently dangerous in your life, I suggest you stay away. If she's stealing from you, taking from you, putting you down, lying to you, and pushing agenda that you don't like, do not deal with her. These are the things that a female will bring to the table, which is toxic and not needed. If she's about you and catering to your needs and helping you build your empire, then that's the woman you need to focus on being with. As simple as that. Don't waste your time with a female. Don't waste your time with a succubus. Don't waste your time with a criminal-minded, mentally ill, bipolar, schizophrenic female. Stay away from them, and you will be happy, content, and safe. Greetings. This is Omar Barasai, a.k.a. Wise Nubia. I want to say that there are people out here who are very young and have beautiful businesses and have accomplished a lot of goals. That is where I want to be. I've worked myself very hard throughout my life, and some people, it's easy. I commend them people, and I want to work with people like that.
I don't know who needs to hear this, but I'm talking to my brethren from the motherland and other lands that we're in, of darkened skin complexion, with full lips, wide nose, curly tight hair, and ancestry based on Southwest Asia, aka so-called Africa. We call it Nubia Kush. Anyway, let me get to the point. Brothers, we have a big issue with our young men in this society. When they're young, they have an adventurous spirit, and sometimes they want to do things that's not cool. We don't need to be hitting and beating them like the slave masters did, our ancestors. And we don't really need to be hitting our children. I really highly recommend you don't, because all it does is give them post-traumatic stress. But you have to curb them from doing things that's negative. And the biggest problem right now is the stealing. For some reason, they just got to take what they want if they're not getting what they want. As fathers, we have to be highly creative, because we're already under the gun. Every time we discipline our son in the open, some European ancestral person that has nothing to do with our culture deems that it's their job to correct us and tell us how to live our life and how to discipline our children, which is absolutely incorrect. Okay, it's beyond Karens and Smiths and Thompsons. We have to completely ignore them. When you're out, when you're dealing with someone who's trying to question your authority on your child, ignore them. Completely ignore them. Don't talk to them. Don't look their way or anything. That is the best way to deal with these nosy, radical individuals that have nothing to do with your culture, your mannerism, or who you are. Perfect example. Try to get a GoFundMe and get them to support you. See, unless you're dead, they're not going to support you. Unless you are pretty much bleeding out like an animal that got hit and put on the side of the freeway, they pretty much will ignore you. And this is why we have to attend to our own, in my opinion. If your son is continuously stealing, Make him hold his hands up as he walks into any store and keep them up throughout the time he's in there. It's a sign showing that he has stole something and he refused to obey. If push comes to shove, every time you go out, take a bandage and wrap his hand up into a fist where he can't grab anything and make him walk out with both his fists tied up like that where he can't grab anything to put in his pocket. Why am I saying this? Because this is better than beating him, hitting him, screaming at him, getting him on ridiculous punishments. If you embarrass him enough, he'll get it and he'll stop doing it. I don't know why they do it. I know if I had a disciplinary who told me not to do it, I wouldn't have did it, but this is not the same. These children of this era have a different mindset. I don't get it. I don't know why they're doing it, but I'm telling you the solutions I'm using to make my son stop stealing. If he have any type of electronic that he like to play, take it away for a week. If he like doing any type of activities that stimulates his internal to have fun, take it away and constantly keep him in your eyesight. Make him sit in the chair, make him do exercise, make him do push-ups, make him do jumping jacks, make him write, "I will not steal thousands of time." Keep him, continue pressuring him on why he did what he did. Don't let up. This is what I recommend men of color do to counter their sons from acting up. Same with daughters, but women, females are usually more emotional. So hopefully you can get them with the emotion. But with the males, you have to make them, shake them up a little. I don't mean literally shaking them and beating them like a horse or animal. You need to mentally get to them and make them recognize you're not playing. Take away everything and keep them by you so they can't do nothing. The worst thing the son wanted to do is be on his daddy, especially when he disobeyed him, and now he has to deal with the consequences. That is my recommendation for men to deal with their sons, okay? Because hurting the body hurt mentally, and that turns them into bullies and evil people that do evil things. But if you discipline them in the way I'm saying, that'll make them think, and they don't want to deal with that embarrassment. And I'm almost positive they will not do it again, at least not anytime soon, because you got to make it have a daunting effect to make them really think about what they did to the level that they like, "Wait a minute, if I do this, he's going to wrap my hands up, he's going to make me hold my hands up in public, and people will be looking at me like I'm strange. I don't think I want to go through all that." So that's what I think will be effective. Okay, respect. Greetings, this is Mr. Mumbaraside. I wanted to encourage men of color to stay away from racial motivated people who will cause calamity in your life just because you are who you are, whether they look like you or of another race. If they're constantly trying to find a way to cause havoc in your life, I highly suggest you maybe stay away from them and not give them any kind of energy whatsoever, because it may save your life. Also, try to deal with people who really care about you. Don't deal with people who are just trying to sell you things, really care nothing about your well-being, and you become a burden or insignificant or problematic to them. Although they may not say it verbally, their actions speak louder. I've encountered these people continuously. I go out my way to meet someone to work with them and find out that they basically have a bias toward me, or they have a condescending behavior pattern toward me that is insignificant to my well-being and a threat to me on all kinds of levels. So I'm not going to support their business or deal with them anymore, because they made it very clear that they are not interested in working with me whatsoever. I had that encounter the other day when I went out to purchase some herbs for my medicine to detox my body and help me get healthier. The person was only trying to find fault in everything I did and didn't really listen to me, wasn't concerned about what I've done, who I am, and what I'm about. And you know, that's a given if you're dealing with them type of people, so it's better to just stay away. If you find individuals that have no interest in your way of life or your concept. Greetings, this is Mr. Mumbaraside, aka Wise Newton. I want to talk about a very strong point of view that I hold close to my heart. A lot of individuals out here of the opposite sex tend to make bold and harsh statements toward men of color in very derogatory ways. They tend to say things that's not very nice to men about men and how they view men. And no one seems to have any say-so to counter that until now, in my opinion. If you're 5'1" and weigh over 300 pounds, over 200 pounds, over 180 pounds, you are very overweight. I'm 5'11", and I weigh under 200 pounds. I weigh under 190 pounds. I'm 58 years old, 5'11", I keep in shape. You know, I still have a lot to learn and a lot to do to keep out of shape. But when you're barely 5'1", and trying to force a man to want to be with you, that's an insult. That's an insult. And a lot of men don't want to tolerate that, especially men who are well off. Hell, especially men who are not well off. We don't want it. So you're under the impression that we have to accept you because we don't have any other choice. You're wrong. Men can go anywhere in the world to find what they need and want. Only in America, in first world countries, do females think that they can control what man desires and control the man's thought pattern about what he should get over what he wants. It saddens me to see that so many women in this society breaks down the mentality of a man by saying, "Well, you get what you don't deserve because we say so. You take what you can get. You're desperate. You're stupid. You're not worthy to get anything other than what we dictate. And if you try to get anything more, we encounter you." To continue what I was saying before I got interrupted, men want certain things, whether they're rich or not. When I see a woman I like, usually under the weight of 130 pounds, whether she's 5'9" or 5'1", she needs to be under 130 pounds, period. I don't want anything other than that. I don't want a woman that has one breast weighing close to 50 pounds, hips weighing over 150 pounds. Why do you have that much weight on you? What are you going through that you have that much weight? I'm not attacking. There's a woman for every man. That's out of my league. I would not deal with someone that weigh more than me and look that kind of way. That's not what I want. That's not what I need. So I'm not going to sit here and try. Another thing a lot of men won't say, most men are tired of trying to give a woman all their money that they work for, and a woman does not go spend it. I don't need a woman to spend my money. I can do that on my own. I don't need a woman to dictate to me how I should run my life when I worked all my life to make my life the way it is. It makes no sense for a man to try to have a woman dictating to him how she thinks he should live his life when she has absolutely nothing to offer but the JJ. Females should reflect on their life and how they're living before they come to a man talking about how he should live their life the way they want him to. That don't make any sense. But you have a large majority of females out here talking that nonsense. And that is why you're single. I'm single by choice. I can easily get a woman because all she wants is money. All she wants is material things. And if I give that to her and then sex her up, she's cool. But that's not all I want in life. I want a woman who will be diligent to work with me, build, believe in what I'm doing, working with me, making sure my health is good like hers, making sure we work as a team. A lot of women are compatible not with that. They will tell you in a hot second, that's too much work. I'm not going in that direction in my life. If I can't have everything I want and you catering to me in every way, then I don't want you in my life, which is preposterous. But they truly believe that. And men who fall for that ends up being very, very upset. More to come. I just want to express myself to this level and get a response. And hopefully men will respond and say that they agree with what I'm talking about. Respect.